Who is the British socialite who had a rumored affair with Prince William? Rose Hanbury's alleged connection to the prince made her famous, but her family was tied to the royals long before those rumors. Rose Hanbury isn't the first in her family to have a connection to the royal family. Her grandmother, Lady Elizabeth Lambert, was a childhood friend of the late Queen Elizabeth II. Lambert's father was close friends with King George VI. Lambert was one of the 8 bridesmaids who escorted Elizabeth on her wedding day to Prince Philip in 1947. When it was Lambert's turn to get married to Mark Longman, Elizabeth, Margaret, and the Queen Mother all attended the nuptials. The friendship between the two women spanned throughout their years as mothers as well. Elizabeth became the godmother to Lambert's eldest daughter, Caroline Longman, and had their daughters continue the tradition of meeting at Buckingham Palace. Rose Hanbury attended Stowe School, one of the most reputable schools in England. Many of its students continue their education at Oxford and Cambridge University. Rose continued her schooling at the Open University in England. Rose then became a model for the agency Storm, singing with them at age 23. While Rose's modeling career didn't reach the echelons that fellow Storm alumnus Kate Moss did, the two women had an interesting connection later in life. Rose's illustrious home, Houghton Hall, which she shares with her husband, David Rock Savage, the Marquess of Cholmondeley. Their home was used as a location for one of Moss's photo shoots. Rose and her sister, Marina Hanbury, both famous socialites, became the talk of the town when they were photographed wearing pink bikinis in Italy with the former Prime Minister of England, Tony Blair. This wasn't her only brush with politics, though. Rose became the researcher for the Conservative Member of Parliament, Michael Gove, but had to quit her job because of severe morning sickness when she became pregnant with twins. After Rose was taken to the Queen Charlotte's Hospital in London, Marina told the Daily Mail, "Rose is absolutely fine now. It was one of those complications you get with twins. Hopefully, she will be allowed home today or tomorrow." Rose Hanbury's husband, David Rock Savage, has two homes. The first, Cholmondeley Castle, is located in Cheshire, England. The castle itself was built in the 19th century, but the land has been in the Cholmondeley family since around 1100 AD. The gardens are open to the public, so tourists can take in the famous Rose Garden, the Temple Garden, and a carefully cultivated path called the Lavinia Walk.
We've got the subtle, we've got the fantastic, we've got lots of color, lots of texture.
While the castle is a jaw-dropping piece of English history, Hanbury and her family live in the second property, Houghton Hall in Norfolk. It is frequently called a Palladian hall due to its classical architecture, influenced by the Italian architect Andrea Palladio. This home also has a lot of history. It was built for Sir Robert Walpole, the first Prime Minister of Great Britain. The home itself is absolutely outrageous. It boasts 106 rooms and houses a museum-worthy collection of both classical and modern art. The home is as expensive as it is opulent, and like Cholmondeley Castle, curious visitors can book tours to explore the grounds and even parts of the interior from April until October each year. Houghton Hall actually has its own Instagram page, with several candid shots of Hanbury, her husband, and their children. So it's safe to assume that Hanbury has a hand in the social media presence of her famous home. It's also very close to Prince William and Princess Catherine when they take up residency at their Norfolk home, Anmer Hall. Rose Hanbury's husband is a man with many titles. His name is David George Philip Cholmondeley, and he's the 7th Marquess of Cholmondeley. At birth, he was the Viscount Malpass and later became the Earl of Rock Savage. In 1990, Cholmondeley became the Lord Great Chamberlain. However, after Queen Elizabeth II died, the role was handed on to Lord Rupert Carrington. Cholmondeley was also a filmmaker in his day, working both as a director and an actor. He directed Other Voices, Other Rooms in 1995 and Shadows in the Sun in 2009. In 2012, he produced the film Una Noche. Cholmondeley met Hanbury in Italy in 2003 at a party, but he had a reputation for bachelorhood, and no one expected them to settle down. However, they did away with these expectations in 2009. They announced that they were engaged. The next day, they announced that they were pregnant. One day after that, they got married at the Chelsea Register office. Afterward, they moved to Houghton Hall. The couple now has 3 children. When the couple announced that they were pregnant and got married the day after, Hanbury was pregnant with twin boys. Their sons are Alexander, Earl of Rock Savage, and heir apparent, and Oliver, Lord Chumley. There was an interesting way in which they decided who the heir would be, which is no small decision, since he inherits the title as well as a multi-million dollar estate. According to the Telegraph, since the sons were born almost exactly at the same time via C-section, they chose the heavier of the twins. A friend told the tabloid, "They have decided that the 8th Marquess will be the boy who weighed more at birth. There was only 8 ounces in it, but they will be a very significant 8 ounces.
England needs an heir."
They later welcomed a daughter, Lady Iris, on Hanbury's Instagram account for their home, Houghton Hall. She also shares photos of her kids. She shared a photo of Iris in the garden with the caption, "Iris enjoying the best smell in the world, wisteria." In another photo, Hanbury shared a photo of one of her sons walking toward their estate. She captioned it, "Homeward bound." Just because she's rich and famous now doesn't mean that Rose Hanbury doesn't get involved in collabs and projects. On May 4th, 2022, Hanbury shared a series of photos on Instagram announcing her collaboration with interior design brand Cabana, linked with her home, Houghton Hall. She captioned the photo, "A night to remember, a candlelit dinner in the marble parlor at Houghton Hall," to celebrate the launch of Cabana X Houghton Tableware Collection. The photos showed an exquisitely laid table with long taper candles and elaborate flower arrangements. While they're beautiful, the tableware doesn't come cheap. One water glass cost $210, a tablecloth cost $495, and a rather ornate piece called the Houghton Hall Silver Swan Vessel cost $1,995. Aside from her modeling career and her marriage, Hanbury is known for something else, and it's a tale as old as time. While there's no confirmation that Rose Hanbury had an affair with Prince William, she's certainly been punished for it. In 2019, The Sun published a piece claiming that there was a feud between Princess Catherine and Hanbury, dubbing the latter Catherine's, quote, rural rival. This rumor began because both families lived in Norfolk, with Hanbury at Houghton Hall and Catherine and William in their country home, Anmer Hall. They were less than 3 miles apart, and The Sun reported that Catherine wanted William to put distance between himself and Hanbury. The scandal was hard on Hanbury, who suddenly became the talk of the area and, quite quickly, the rest of the world. Some turned on Hanbury, leaving her lonely and isolated. The Daily Mail reported, "The most loyal friends are sticking by her, but others, they haven't." Her reputation and her social standing were hit hard by these rumors to the point where they allegedly disrupted even her marriage. Shortly after, in June 2019, when Hanbury attended a state dinner at Buckingham Palace in honor of former President Donald Trump, she wasn't wearing her wedding ring.
"Mr. President."
While it's the royal way to never complain or explain, the rumors about Rose Hanbury and Prince William's affair reached such a fever pitch that both sides claimed to consider legal action, according to the Daily Mail. At the time, however, sources claimed that both families stalled on the idea because none of the outlets reporting on the alleged affair had anything substantive with which to back up their stories. The problem was, of course, that the rumors besmirched both the marriages of Prince William and Princess Catherine, and that of Hanbury and her husband. Not only were Catherine and Hanbury friends before the scandal, but William and Chumley were also reportedly friends, and the situation became increasingly awkward. At last, and somewhat surprisingly, the royals did take action, turning to the London law firm Harbottle & Lewis, who sent a letter to a British publication calling the rumors false, highly damaging, and a breach of privacy. Nevertheless, this hasn't stopped countless publications from covering the story. The rumored affair certainly made life harder for Hanbury, but that hasn't stopped her from participating in royal events. Before the gossip broke, she was a familiar face at Buckingham Palace. Then, of course, there was the state dinner for former President Donald Trump in June 2019, where Hanbury was present without her wedding ring. In March 2022, Hanbury and her husband attended the memorial service for the late Prince Philip at Westminster Abbey. She wore a black pillbox hat and a long black coat dress to honor the late prince. In September 2022, when Queen Elizabeth II died, Hanbury also attended her funeral, arriving before the procession of the immediate family. Rose Hanbury is involved in several charitable organizations. In fact, she and Princess Catherine are patrons of the same organization, East Anglia's Children's Hospices, or EACH. Catherine is the royal patron, while Hanbury is listed among the regular patrons. Hanbury joined each as a patron in 2018, and she was photographed visiting build sites for the hospice's new location. In fact, it was this patronage that linked Catherine and Hanbury in 2016 when the latter hosted a charity gala dinner at her home, Houghton Hall, to raise money for each. Catherine and Prince William attended and were greeted by Hanbury and David Chumley. The event was glamorous, with five Michelin-star chefs cooking dinner for the guests. Both women, regardless of their relationship, continue to support the hospice.